Hello and welcome to our community meetup to the topic SAP API automation with help of UiPath. First of all, I would like to do a short introduction. So first of all, it's me, Director of Product Management for SAP. I'm coming from SAP world, I would say from SAP space. I have seen a lot of different SAP projects, implementation projects, testing projects, migration projects, and in the last 10 years, I'm taking care about SAP automation. SAP automation in general means SAP automation, like SAP robotic process automation, and also SAP test automation. And today, together with Stefan, we are going to show you a great stuff. So Stefan, please introduce yourself.
Yes, hello to all. Nice to stay here. At the stage, my name is Stefan Schnell. I live in Germany. I work for the BWI, the service provider for the German Federal Armed Forces. My task is at the moment to realize an RPA service for the German Armed Forces, a very interesting task. And and in my history, I work as an ABAP developer a long time, 18 years. And so I have a good combination between SAP on the one hand and RPA and UiPath on the other hand. And that's the reason I want to present today different solutions, how you can connect SAP on the one hand and UiPath on the other hand on an other level, on an API level together.
Okay, great, Stefan. Thank you for introduction. So guys, let me move on and give you an overview of agenda for today. So we have just accomplished introduction. In the next part, I will give a high level overview of what we are doing for SAP automation from UiPath's point of view. And then I will immediately hand over to Stefan to show you live as much as we can how to automate SAP with help of API. Yeah, and at the end, we will have a session. So open questions, answers. So raise your concerns even during the session in the chat, and we will try to answer them. And yes, so UiPath and SAP. So I'm calling this Stronger Together. Yeah, so we are partner of SAP. We are working together with SAP. We are serving our customers with SAP automation. Yeah, and here we are speaking about, once more, about robotic process automation and about test automation across the whole enterprise, across the whole platform. So, and the first step for all customers starting thinking about automation, and here I just want to put in comparison what we have, where we are. So first step for everyone is automation of user interface. Here it's a clear picture. With UiPath, we are able to automate all SAP user interfaces, starting from SAP Vingui. Here I even grab the screenshot. So I think it's R2 or R3 system, right? So there is an evolution of different user interfaces of SAP. And today we are supporting all of them, even the newest one, SAP Vingui 7.7t, which was released almost 2 weeks ago. Yeah. So it's here, and we all, and SAP even, right, we are moving to the web interface. So web interface of SAP is SAP Fiori. So today they're calling this like SAP Fiori 3.0, the latest, the modern one. We can perform UI automation on these interfaces. We can find the right elements. We can click the buttons. So automation of any kind of SAP systems is here. SuccessFactors, Hybris, Ariba, S4HANA, I put S4HANA in the cloud, Concur, maybe not relevant anymore because of no traveling, right? So a lot of UI interfaces. And guess what? As a partner of SAP, we are even certified by SAP for Veeam GUI automation. We are certified by SAP for SAP BAPE automation, and Stefan will speak about it. Yeah. So what does it mean, certification? So it means that we are following technical standards for implementation, that we know how to automate your system. We know how to speak to your system. And guess what? We know how not to make any troubles in your system. Yeah. So this is a certification proof that we can do the automation right. Okay. And this was user interfaces. And guess what? Today we are not going to speak about user interfaces. We are going to speak about API automation, automation of technical interfaces, of non-visual interfaces. And why that, right? The super simple answer is user interfaces are changing a lot. There are a lot of dependencies on different frameworks. I don't know, let's grab web interface. You have Chrome, you have Mozilla, you have Internet Explorer, Fiori interface is dynamic. I don't know, Veeam GUI is not available for Fiori. So there are a lot of dependencies. And with API, we have direct access to this technical interface. It's super fast. Interfaces are, once more, I will use this super, like every second sentence, it's super stable. API interfaces are not changing a lot. They're standardized. It means the automation you have built in, I would say, in one system, you can reuse in another system. It's a standardized way of doing automation. Yeah, it's super robust, right? So it's scalable. Performance, yeah? So performance, my lovely example, I don't know, create sales order. To create sales order, human being need 10 minutes, yeah? To use UI automation, right? You will create sales order in 2 minutes, but guess what? Doing API automation, you are able to create sales order in 2 seconds, yeah? So from 10 minutes to 2 seconds or even milliseconds, yeah? So this is a performance, this is a speed, yeah? Once more, unattended execution. It's going under user interface. You don't see actually nothing, and you will see from the demos that you do not see nothing. So it's happening in background. It's fast, it's easier, and it's covering once more. Here you see I put SAP technologies which are available, which we can automate. And today we will have focus on some of them. Okay. So I would say from my side, this was high level overview UI automation in comparison to API automation or non-visual interfaces automation and their benefits. I would say with this, let me hand over to Stefan and give you more insights with this lovely live demo. Okay. Stefan?
Yeah, sure.
It's yours.
I will share my screen. I hope you see my screen now.
Yes.
Okay, great. So at first, I want to talk a little bit about the architecture, about the layer architecture of SAP. So we have three layers with SAP. So Lev talked about the front end server, the user interfaces that we normally used in automation context of RPA, but we have two other layers. The second layer is the application layer. And that's what I'm talking now in the presentation, how to automate a level deeper as the presentation layer. Last but not least, we have a database layer, but the database layer is not in the focus. We concentrate in this presentation on the application layer. Yeah, here we have another presentation of what I said. You have at the presentation layer the UI automation. You see on the right side the different kinds of UIs you can work with an SAP system. And the next level, the application layer, so we can automize it with API automation. And there we have different possibilities. The first one, or yeah, technically seen the only one is the remote function calls. So we will see in the presentation that the business API is a special form of RFC automation, and using of ABAP, the programming language of SAP, in this context is also a special form, or the using of a special function module, which is also remote enabled. Yeah, that was my intro. I want to show you at first a data model called S-Fly. SAP created that a long time ago for training purposes. And in my opinion, it is a very good playground for any kind of experiments. So I will switch to my VM. Okay, here we are. And oops, I will log in. So here we are. At first, I will show you the package where you can find this playground. This could be very interested to know where you can find the tables, where you can find the function modules, all those kinds of objects in the SAP content where you work with. So and in this playground, so we have here some dictionary objects. You see we have here a lot of tables in this data model. It is a playground for it's a flight model, so you can book flights, you can book some meal and all those kinds. You can book tickets, and you can find all this information that we use with RFC calls, with Bay API calls, and with ABAP calls. You can find all this information in tables, and also the information are available in this packages. Are available in this packages here in function groups, in function modules, and here you can find the BARPI calls, maybe BARPI flight get detail as example. Okay, here that is this. And you see here in this different packages that the model that we use is available in this transaction called SE80. It is a developer transaction, so you need a developer key on your system to use that. But I recommend to get a developer key, because it is very important. If you need some information from an SAP system to have this access in a development system, and in my opinion, for an RPA developer, it should be very easy to get this access if you are work in context with an SAP system. So you have also here the possibility to call a repository info system, and here you can search for database tables. No, so yeah, if you know the table name, you can here input your table name. You can input structures. You can input if you know which function module do you want to use. Maybe here BARPI flight get detail. So you can search it here, or if you don't know the whole word, and you can search for a group of functions which are available. That do you want to know? Das will ich natürlich nicht. And this is a very good point to start for searching information in an SAP system. Yes. So let's jump back to the slides. So I have shown you the package, our data model where we work with now in the presentation, and now I want to talk about the different API approaches. So you can see we have three different technical approaches. RFC is the first one, BAPI is the second one, and the ABAP, the programming language in SAP environments, is the third one. And yeah, the remote function calls or remote enabled function calls is standard for technical communication between SAP systems. And in SAP systems, you have a great count of RFC functions. So I will show you that a little bit. I switch back to my SAP system and jump to a table that would be very interesting to know, a table where you can all find all functions, all function modules who are defined in an SAP system. And here I open that table. So here can I search for a function name if I know the function name, or I can search here for the function mode. And here I have R for the RFC modules, also function modules who are remote enabled. And if I run that, I will show you the number of entries you see in my systems, in my system, and it is a very tiny system, are 14,000, more than 14,000 remote enabled function modules available. And you can use these modules in your UiPath context. And yeah, the first question that I ask is, how can I find the right function module? So at first we have seen the table where all function modules are, which function modules are available. And we have here, database table, So, and here we have a table. You see it has a language key, it has the function name and the short text of the function module. And this is very important if you search for a function module. So I will looking for English language, which are only available on my system, English and German. So, and if I look maybe for, maybe for system, you must be careful if you search for in this table, upper and lower case are different in this context. And here I find, you see more than 200 entries where the word system is in the short text of the function module. It contains the short text contains the word system, and so you have the possibility to search over. I will look for another one. So you have the possibility to search for special words in the short text to find exact the function module you can use for your requirement. You can see here in the language key, it is only English language. I will delete the language key, and you see now we have a lot more. Most function modules, the short descriptions of the function modules are not, the short text is not available in different languages. So it is better to search in German, in English, or if you have customized function modules, to search in your language. So you have the possibility to find the short text on the one hand, and to find the function name. And if you have the function name, let us look. So it is German and English. So I will copy the text, and now we can look in the table tfdir if it is the correct one. So if this function module is remote enabled, and we see here, okay, it is not. No, so this is a method where you can find out manually over the description of the function module to see if this function module could be possible to use for your requirement. Yeah. Okay. That's a tiny step beside. So on the other hand, we have the business application programming interface. The BARPI is a formal defined interface. BARPI is an function module, which is an RFC function module, but it has a specification of its interface and a specification of its technology. So you can, in a normal case, if you can use RFC, you can use the BARPI also. It makes no difference. And last but not least, we have the advanced business application programming language. So in SAP environments called ABAP, so formerly known as Allgemeiner Berichtsaufbereitungsprozessor in German. And we have a function module called RFC ABAP install and run. And with this function module, we have the possibility to transfer ABAP reports or ABAP programs from our UiPath installation to the SAP backend to do some things in the backend and to deliver us a result back. Yeah, okay. I said that we have three different API automation approaches, but we have one technical method, and this technical method is RFC. Okay. I will show you how you can see if your function module is an RFC function module. I will change back to the repository browser, and here I open an function module, and we have here some different tabs. And in the first tab, you have here a checkbox. And in a normal case, if you create a function module, the checkbox is set to a normal function module. This means you can the function module use only in the context of your SAP system. If I switch the checkbox to remote enabled module, that means that you can use it inside your SAP system, but you can use it also outside from your SAP system. So it is a tiny switch to create a function module who is remote enabled. Oops, and yeah, back to the presentation. So yeah, here what I said. Yeah, so you have here different documentations where you can find how to use RFC or BARPI or something else from remote function calls. On the one hand, the SAP connector from Microsoft, you can find it directly at SAP, at the SAP site. And the other one are available in the UiPath forum. And I will show you at the end of the presentation where you can find detailed information and all this information that we present here. Yeah, okay, so now we have seen a lot about SAP and nothing about UiPath. So I have here prepared a tiny environment. At first, I want to show you how you can use RFC calls, but my first step is to install the Microsoft Visual C runtime libraries to use the .NET connector. If you have installed the SAP GUI for Windows, it is not necessary, but if you need to install the .NET connector from SAP, it is necessary to install these Visual C runtimes too. Okay, I have installed these, so, and I have prepared here different environments, and at first I want to install the SAP Enco package, which I have built it by myself. You can build it very easily by yourself too. Collect the data from your SAP GUI Windows installation and pack it in a NudgeJet packet. And so you can use it on the same way I do it. I have described it in the this in the UiPath forum. So it is, oops, pardon. So it is no secret to do that. Okay, here I have the main workflow, and the first step I have to do is to activities to add a variable. The name is not important. Important is that you add a variable of the SAP Enco library. And if you have done that, you can use inside the invoke code activity anything you like from the SAP Enco connector. So I have described a tiny, I have prepared a tiny example, and I will copy that into my test process. So here we are, and I will refresh that. So, and here I have an workflow. Any second, please. So, and let us look at first a little bit at the code. Interesting. So here you can see the code I use. It is in it is code so far so well, but it is easy to understand in my opinion. So we have here a few sections in this code. The first section is to define here from line 9 to line 14 the connection parameters to the system. And here I define the function in line 18, which function module I call. Here in line 19, I invoke the function module, and in line 20, I get a structure, and the last four lines, I got the result back I want to know from this function module. So let us parallel look at the system. So we change to the function builder back. So I want to see the function module, and the function module I use here is RFC system info. So, and you see here in the different tabs, we have no import parameters, but we have some export parameters, and that's what we find here. So RFCSI export. You see, we have here these parameter from this type. So, and here with forward navigation, I can jump into the structure, and that's what I exactly do here. I get the value of this structure of the field RFC host, and you see here RFC host is one field in the structure from type character with a length 8. So, and so I get here this information back. And that was in a normal case all we have to do here. And if I run that now, I assume it works, and it delivers me now back the information that I have requested. So RFC host, the name of the SAP system, the database, and different things that we have available here in the structure. It needs a little bit time because it must connect to the SAP system, and you see here it needs 22 seconds. And you see it delivers me back my host name, my system ID, my database host, and my database system. And on this way, you can use RFC connections. One way, you can use RFC connections via invoke code activity. But it is very good to know all these steps that I have shown you now. It is more or less complex. If you know where you are searching for or what you are searching for, it is all good. But in the most cases, we don't know that exactly. So, and here I have written a program called RFM code generator. And with this RFM code generator, you have the possibility to detect all this information in one program. So here I have to give the normal information that you know from your standard SAP login. So I test the connection. It needs a little bit of time. Okay, connection successful. And what I have shown you in the steps before with the table TF, DIR and TF, TIT, this is packed here in a function. So I can search here with asterisks. So we searched before for system info. So without any language, I will search for that. And you see it found 21 remote enabled functions modules in this case. And if I press here with a double click on the function module name, you can see it delivers me here different information about the short text in different languages. It delivers me the interface. So this is not a very good interface, too short. Ach, meine Herren. Ah, here is better. So you have here different imports, exports, and you see you have here types of string, type of structure. And here you have the possibility to generate the code. That's exactly the same code which I used here in this workflow. So I will open that code. Okay, zack. So, and here we use this function module, and I will use that function module here too. You have also the possibility to search for the technical name. So, and here only export you see, and you have here the structure. And what can I here do? I can generate the code that you that we here use in the code editor is now available here in the code tab of the generator. And this code, this code, it is possible to expand this code. You see, we have here an export of a structure, and I don't know what is in the structure. So I make a double click on this and I see, oh, here it is a great structure with many fields. And I have the possibility here to mark the fields and to generate set or get method. And I can do it here now, and you see that the structure RFCSI export, which is declared here, so that the fields, I get the information back here. And now I can take this code and put it directly here into my invoke code activity. But I want to show that it works. Right line. CB boost. So I hope this is enough. Yes, okay, we will see. Okay, no error. We don't need that anymore. It is only an example. Save and run. And so with this RFM code generator, you have the possibility to search very easily the function module you need. And the code generator, you can use the code directly inside your invoke code activity, and you see it delivers the correct result of ABAP 7.02, what we see before in the other example. Yes, that's one way to use remote enabled function modules.
Stefan, yeah. before we moving to Bappe, here's a question. Can I assign values returned by RFC function call to any variable?
Sure. That is possible. You can here in my workflow, it is not prepared, but you can have some import arguments. And in your workflow, you can add here the parameters, and you can set it if your function module has some import arguments. In our case, this function module has no import arguments, so I don't can present this. But yes, it is possible. Sure, is that possible?
Okay, thank you very much. So now show us SAP Bappe.
Okay, thank you. Good. The business application programming interface. Yeah, I told it before, it is a standardized programming interface. So SAP have learned in the history, you have seen we have 14,000 RFC function modules in a system. And each programmer has his own priority to define variables, to define import parameters, export parameters, tables, and all those things. So we have a wide range of technical approaches inside RFC function modules. And Bappe is a way from SAP to standardize it. In this case, that SAP said, okay, we take a look from the business perspective to RFCs. And yeah, we will. So I will. We can close that. So, and now we will take a look with the Bappe Explorer. And you see here, it is a well-structured system to find business application programming modules. In this case, we are so sorry, yeah, all those components. Any second, here I want to go. So you have here a structure of a business perspective. You see financials, you see knowledge management, and in my system is not very much available. So I use a basis components. And in this case, ABAP Workbench, and here we have the S flight or the flight where I introduced at the beginning the data model for a sandbox, for our sandbox. No? And you see here that SAP structured this, and so you can search for your requirement if you search for Bappe. So we have here a flight, e.g. as example, get detail, and you see here it is well documented what this function do, nodes, and so a lot of information are here available in the Bappe Explorer. So we have here the function module, and this is what we seen before. You can jump directly into the remote enabled function module. So we can take a look at the attributes. You see here it's remote enabled. And that's another perspective to function modules, how to use that into the content of the business. So, and in UiPath, you have the possibility to use that too. So I will close that and I will create a new process. And create, okay, just a second, please. At first, it is necessary to install the SAP.NET connector. So I hope it is possible. I have prepared that here. So you can download the .NET connector directly from the SAP portal. So very important is here to install the Encore in the global assembly cache. Okay. Okay, that's all. And now for our automation workflow, it is necessary to install the UiPath BAPI activity. I have prepared that, so I don't use an public repository. I have download all the necessary libraries into my local account, and I installed that directly from my local directory. So, and now it is here available in the app integration. So at first I must open my workflow and add a sequence to define my application scope. And it is, yeah, very easy. It is exactly the same as we saw it in the RFM code generator. So I test my connection. Yeah, it needs a little bit of time to test it for the first time. So connection successful. Oops. So, and I want to copy it directly here into the properties. So, and I'm a little bit lazy. I have here prepared the password, so I can copy and paste it here inside. So that's all. And now my preparation is done. What I can do now is to invoke the SAP BAPI. Here, yeah, we search for our example. Here it is from the S flight table. Oops, we have oops. Oh, pardon. RP flight get detail. So here we are, and. Here we have the interface of the function module, and now we can use it. And it is very easy, in my opinion, to use it here now. At first, I will show you one step back. The data model that I have showed you at the beginning. It could be possible that the data tables are empty at your system. So you have the possibility to use a generator, which okay, which fills the table. It's a data generator and it fills all the table we need for the flight data model. It's not necessary to do that here now because I have this was my preparation. If you look at the table S flight, and you can see here the number of entries, and here we can find some information, and this are the information we need here inside this function module. So I have here maybe the carrier ID AA, I have the connection ID 17, and I have the flight date. And here two things are very important. The date format. This, you see here it's a string with 8 characters, and you see here 10 characters with points. But in the SAP data table, the year is in the front, the month is in the middle, and the day is at the last. And it is necessary for you, if you put in some variables here or something else, that you use the correct format. And it is different from this, what you have seen here. Yeah, and to get the information, we have here the output, the flight data. It is a data row. We know it's a structure. So, and I can define only with a control K a variable data. So that's all. So, and that's all I have to do. Now I have the possibility to output the information I'm searching for. Here I have flight data. So, and here I have to give the column name. And it is a good idea to look at the function module. In our case, pardon, it was BARPI flight detail. Yeah, okay, it's the correct one. So you had seen here the interface, and we want to know the flight data value. And you see here it's a structure, and it is from this type. And if you double click on it, you jump forward to the structure, and now here are the column names of the structure. And I want to know, from which city comes the fly. So I put it in here. I must convert it to string. And I want to know what's the, flight data. What's the target of the fly? So save that and run that. So, and we see now that's very easy, in my opinion, to use BARPI function modules. You see here, we fly from New York to San Francisco. It would be a great holiday at the moment to do that. You see, it is very easy to use that. And if you have access to the to an SAP system, you can find out your information about the columns or something else very, very easily. Okay. Let us do the last step to talk a little bit about application, advanced business application programming language of an SAP system, how we can use it inside UiPath. Ah, okay, so then we will jump back. I will close that. Okay, and open a new one. Any second, please. So the ABAP runner, which I use now, is prepared. If you have installed an SAP GUI for Windows, you have nothing more to do. You can use it easily, install it and use it. So I will install it. So accept, and so here we are. So I have prepared a few examples. So ABAP test, I will copy that into my project folder. So, and here in my activities, I have now in programming SAP the possibility to install and run an ABAP report. So, I will open my workflow, zack, and take that inside. Yeah, I see the time. I see I need a little bit of more time. so we have here the same to define our connection parameters. Here's a password again. I have prepared that here. And the username, and I have to define the application server. Oh, okay, that's all in this definition. What I have to do now is to load my ABAP report. In this case, I read a text file. The text file I've prepared, which are available here. And let me show you what this report do. So you see here now, it's a very, very easy ABAP report. It writes only hello world from, and it delivers back the system ID of the SAP system. So, and all I have to do now is here to define where my ABAP code is stored, and here where the ABAP code comes from. So all is well now, and here my output. Oops, pardon. So, and now we will see what these call will deliver me back. ABAP output. Okay, that's all. And now let us run. And I hope we see the perfect result, hello world from our system ID. Yeah, you see it needs sometimes a little bit of time. And you have the possibility, in the meantime, I will tell you a little bit more. You have the possibility to use any code inside these ABAP report. okay, you see here it delivers back hello world from NSP from my system ID. And what I want to show you is you can use any code. I have here a tiny example to where you see it is a little bit more complex select statement. And the select statement, I loop over the result of my select statement to write different function module names and short texts, as we see here from table TFDIR and TFTIT. So you all what you can do in your ABAP is it is possible to do that into this code. Not UI, but functions to call non-remote enabled function modules and all those things. But here a very important hint. This function module is not available on production systems. It is only available in development and quality assurance systems. Okay. Yeah, you can find the ABAP runner at the marketplace. So we have seen the demonstration. So I'm at the end. I can told you much more about all these things, but my hour is over. You can meet me at UiPath Forum. You can meet me at the SAP community at LinkedIn, at my private site, wherever you want. If you have questions, don't hesitate to ask. And last but not least, I want to show you in the forum where you can find the information from this presentation. Here you can find in the UiPath forum a knowledge document. And in this knowledge document, you see here the version history. In this knowledge document, all information I'm talked about here in the presentation, you can find it in this document. And also in the UiPath community, you find collection of links to different posts on tutorials on SAP C# and more. So that's all from my side. Oops.
Thank you very much, Stefan. Maybe you can show also shortly. So it was a great feedback actually from Guy saying how cool is RFM code generator. So just to let everyone know, RFM code generator can be also find in forum, right?
Yeah, sure. The RFM code generator is freely available. You can use it inside companies or private, whatever you want. And you can find the link to the code generator in the UiPath forum. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. Guys, we have last 10 minutes. If there are any questions, feel free to unmute yourself and raise your questions, and we are going to answer them.
Hi again. So I just wanted to let everyone know that the mute button is now available for everyone, so you don't need to type in the questions. You can unmute yourself and ask them.
Okay, sounds good that everything was clear. So the question which was also many times asked, so the recording, guys, will be available and you can replicate the steps Stefan showed us. So this will be available, and yes, you can watch the recording. I would say from this side, thank you very much from us. Thank you very much, Stefan, for this deep dive into SAP. So personally, I have learned a lot even during the preparation of this webinar. So really, really, really good stuff.
Thank you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you, guys, and speak to you soon.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you, Lev and Stefan, for your presence and your time and your effort.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.